there's a question of my heart. You got it, it don't belong to anyone but you. Hey, if there's a question of my
heart. How do we start to talk about 10 years of us being together?
Well, we first started off because I was hungry.
Well, this is what happened. We were in class, it was an afternoon class. Now, mind you, the semester before, he was in the class that I was in, and I didn't even recognize him. I didn't notice him. I turned in my paperwork.
She didn't say 2 words.
I'm sorry, I'm an overachiever, and I do my work, and I'm amazing at it, and I go home. Because it was an 8 o'clock class. I'm not trying to talk to anybody in the morning and get to know them. So, no, all of our semester, we didn't talk to him. Second semester happened, and it was a night class. It was from 6 to 9. So, by 7 o'clock, my stomach, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so hungry. Like, oh, I'm going to eat. I'm a freshman, so I didn't have a car. That was going to be a problem. So I looked to my left, and there was this guy sitting there. And I said, do you have a car? I didn't ask her a name, how you doing? Just let's get to the point. Do you have a car? Thank God he did. So he said, yes, I do have a car. And okay, cool. What are you doing later on today? When you were playing to the evening, didn't tell me. You know, in my head, I just wanted a cheeseburger. Really, that's clearly, I just wanted a trip to McDonald's. he said it was his birthday that day. And I'm like, what? Your birthday? What are your plans?
All I had to do on my birthday was actually just write a paper. We didn't have any plans at the time, so she just felt it was in her best interest and in mine to just spend it with her. So I said, sure, why not? You know, nothing wrong with that. And went to this little Chinese restaurant and we sat and we talked and just got to know each other for a little bit. So after that, said our goodbyes, see you later, Mr. Brown, and parted ways. Well, she was upset with me because I didn't call her for like a week. And I told her my excuse was I actually lost her phone number. Mind you, I had a cell phone at the time, but I forgot what the number was. So she was upset with me for it when she saw me the following week. So, but she wasn't too mad because here we are 10 years later, and September 10th of this year, we're getting married. So, I mean, you weren't too mad, were you?
Maybe. Well, everything happened for a reason.
You weren't too mad, were you?
I mean, no. Nice. I'm not so mad.
She wasn't mad.
But we're just blessed to have, you know, our family and friends be a part of this moment. Just because it's been a decade. So we met each other at 18. Now we're entering into our 30s as husband and wife. So it's going to be an awesome time. September 10th is going to be a great day. And we are just so blessed that we're still in love with each other and that we made it through all these different states. So,
different stages of life.
If you made it through Fort Lauderdale, Florida, we made it through North Carolina. I stayed in Missouri for 2 years, and now we're here. So just happy, and I hope he's happy.
Yeah, I'm waiting for September to get here so we can both say happy with each other. You know, it's going to be an exciting day for everybody involved, including the people there to watch it. I think I'm having a good time. I don't know about you. I know I have.
Of course, we're having a good time. It's going to be the best day of our lives.
We got forever.
Yep.
We got forever. So I love you.
Have my heart, baby. Wow. You got. Don't belong to anyone but you. Hey, if there's a question of my love, you got it. Baby, don't worry, I got plans for you. Yeah, baby, I've been making.
Planets. I always feel like I'm a planet, and these other women that are kind of moving through this solar system with me. And marriage is like you decide to jump off of your planet across to another planet. And you can only do it when one planet passes real close. And you look and you go, hey, I think I could jump across.